finding instantaneous rate of change of the function negative 4x squared minus 6 at the point x equals 2. First of all, instantaneous rate of change of the function is derivative of the function f prime at x. So we need to find derivative using limit definition and then plug in 2 to the derivative that you found. And now let me explain you why derivative is instantaneous rate of change. Here is the function f at x. What the limit definition of the derivative says? In the top you have difference in the values of the function, in the bottom you have difference in the values of the argument. Starting point is x and you finish at x plus h. So difference between x values will be h, difference between values of the function is here. This reminds you formula of the average rate of change f at x2 minus f at x1 over x2 minus x1. This is average rate of change. And what do you make in this formula? You make these two guys very close to each other. You make these two guys very close to each other because h goes to zero. So instead of average rate of change, you take the rate of change at the point and you call it instantaneous. Now let's do computation here. So we need to do difference quotient for the quadratic function, and then we need to find limit of the difference quotient and plug in number 2. So first step, I will start from f at x plus h. It will be negative 4 times x plus h squared minus 6. So, formula square of the sum, x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. Parenthesis here. Let's multiply by negative 4. Negative 4x squared minus 8x h minus 4h squared and minus 6. Now, let's do f at x plus h minus f at x. I do this step. On this step, you always have a lot of opposites. So, if you didn't get the opposite, that means that you made a mistake somewhere. So, f at x plus h is negative 4x squared minus 8xh minus 4h squared minus 6. Let's subtract function f at x. When you subtract function f at x, you have minus negative plus minus negative plus. So, all together, you will obtain negative 4x squared minus 8xh minus 4h squared minus 6 plus 4x squared and plus 6. So I have opposites. Negative 6, positive 6, 0. Negative 4x squared, positive 4x squared, 0. So what is left from the whole expression? You have negative 8 xh minus 4h squared. Now, here is the thing. You can factor out h from the both. And why do you need so? Because next step is actually divide by h. So if I factor out h, I will get negative 8x minus 4h inside of the parentheses. So let's do f at x plus h minus f at x over h now. It will be h times negative 8x minus 4h. You divide it by h. H will be cancelled out. So the whole difference quotient is here. It is negative 8x minus 4h. I do not have space here, so let me use this part of the board to do the limit of the difference quotient. So I will get limit of negative 8x minus 4h when h approaches to the zero. If h approaches to the zero, this guy goes to zero, and the whole limit will be negative a times x. And this is derivative of the function, remember? So, you found derivative. The only thing that is left is evaluate this derivative at x equals 2. So, let's evaluate it at 2. F prime at 2 will be negative a times 2, that is negative 16.